Now first let us multiply two decimal numbers 0.1 and 0.1. So 0.1 is a decimal number and again 0.1 is also a decimal number. Now let us multiply these two decimal numbers and we will find their product. So first we will see the pictorial representation of 0.1. So let us take 10 equal rectangles . So there are 10 equal rectangles of equal size. Now these horizontal rectangles denote the first decimal 0.1. So here 0.1, here we will take first decimal into second decimal, then we will find the product. So the first decimal is 0.1 into again the second decimal is 0.1, then we will find what is their product. So here horizontal rectangles represent the first decimal 0.1. so 0.1 can be written as 1/10 into, so here one part out of 10 equal parts. So in this one part, first part, now again we will write 0.1 as 1/10. Now we will draw the vertical rectangles. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. So column wise 10 rectangles and row wise also 10 rectangles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now first, so out of 10 parts we will shade one part. So row wise we will shade only one part out of 10 parts. So instead of shading, I am drawing circles 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this first row represents 1/10. So there are 10 rows. So out of 10 rows, we are drawing the circles in only one row. So these horizontal row represents 1/10. And again, we will multiply this by again 1/10. So this represents vertical rectangles. So in this vertical rectangles, for the second decimal I am drawing triangles. So 1, so this is also 1/10. So out of 1, 2, 3, so up to 10 rectangles, so we have shaded only one rectangle. So this represents 1/10. Now what is their product? So we know that 1 ones are 1 by 10 tens are 100. Now here also we will write the product in the decimal form. Now small squares, how many are there? So there are 100, 10 tens are 100 squares. So out of 100 squares, so where the two shaded regions are there, in how many squares the two shaded regions are there? Two shaded region means both circle and triangle, means first decimal and second decimal. So that is only one part. There is circle and triangle in only one square out of 100 such squares. So this equal to 1 by 100, and this can be written as 0.01. Now let us find the another product of two decimal numbers. So 0.2 into 0.3. So what is the product of these two decimal numbers? So 0.2 can be written as 2 by 10 into 0.3 can be written as 3 by 10. Now what is the product? So 2 by 10 means out of 10 rows we have to shade 2 rows. So only one row is shaded with circles, and we will shade the second row with circles only. So this horizontal shaded region represents 2 by 10 with circles. Now vertically we should shade 3 columns out of 10. Now vertical shaded region is represented by triangles. So already first column is shaded. Now we will shade the second and third columns. So second column is shaded, now we will shade the third column. So two horizontal rows are represented by 2 by 10 and three vertical columns are represented by 3 by 10. Now what is their product? So this equals to 2 threes are 6 by 10 tens are 100. Now out of 100 equal parts, equal squares, now how many are represented by both circle and triangle? So if you find here, we can find, if you see here, we can find in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. In 6 squares, both circles and triangles are there, means 2 by 10 and 3 by 10. So out of 100 squares, in 6 squares both shaded regions are there. So that is why their product is 6 out of 100. So this can be written as 0.06. So 6 by 100 can be written as 0.06. So but this pictorial representation of the finding product of two decimal numbers is time consuming, it takes long time. Then how to multiply any decimal numbers without using pictorial representation? Then we will find the product of 0.2 and 0.3. So here, so first we will multiply these two decimal numbers by ignoring the decimal point. So let us multiply just 2 by 3, then we get the product 6. But in the given decimal numbers, in the first number after decimal point there is one digit, in the second decimal number after decimal point there is one digit. So total, so 1 plus 1, there will be 2 digits in the product. So we should write the decimal point such that after decimal point there will be 2 digits. So we write the product as 0.06. So only one digit 6 is there. Then we will place 10, then put decimal point, then 0. So here, in the first decimal, one digit after decimal point. In the second decimal number, there is one digit after the decimal point. So there will be two digits after the decimal point in the product. So then we write 0.06 as the product. Now in this way, we can multiply any other decimal numbers without using pictorial representation. For example, 0.4 into 0.12. So then how to multiply so these two decimal numbers? Now first you will multiply the two decimal numbers ignoring the decimal point. So we multiply 4 into 12, 12 fours are 48. Then where we should draw the, where we should plot the decimal point in the given product? Now in the first decimal number there is one digit after the decimal point, and in the second decimal number also there are two digits after the decimal point. So then totally there will be three digits after the decimal point in the product. Then we write 0.048. So after decimal point there will be three digits, 1, 2, 3. So here one digit, here two digits. So 1 plus 2, there should be three digits after the decimal point. So we write 0.048 as the product of the two decimal numbers 0.4 and 0.12. Now let us go to the next topic, multiplication of decimal numbers by 10, 100 and 1000, etc. Now multiplication of decimal numbers by 10, 100 and 1000. So when a decimal number is multiplied by 10, 100, 1000 or 10,000, so we need not multiply the two decimal numbers as usual, but we can find directly their product. Now let us see how to find the product of a decimal number and 10, 100 or 1000. Now for example, 2.34 is multiplied by 10 and 2.34 is multiplied by 100 and 2.34 is multiplied by 1000. So let us observe these three products. Now 2.34 can be written as 234 by 100 into 10. So this equals to here 0, 0 cancel, and 234 by 10 can be written as 23.4. Now 2.34 again 234 by 100 into 100. So this equals here 2 zeros, 2 zeros cancel. So we get 234.0. Next question, 2.34 into 1000. So 2.34 can be written as 234 by 1000 by 100 into 1000. Now this equals to, here also 2 zeros, 2 zeros cancel, and 234 into 10, 2340. So then here also we can write 0.0. Now see, when you find, when you multiply any decimal number by 10, 100, 1000, the digits in the product are same as the digits in the given decimal number. So in the given decimal number we have the digits 2, 3, 4, and even in the product also we have the same digits 2, 3, 4. Here also see the digits in the given decimal number 2, 3, 4, and digits in the product also 2, 3, 4. So here also 2, 3, 4 and 2, 3, 4. But what is changing while multiplying any decimal number with 10, 100 or 1000? See, we are multiplying 2.34 by 10 and by 100 and by 1000. Then what is change in the product when compared with the given decimal number? Now here 10 in 10, 10 is there. So then here decimal point is shifted to the right by one digit. So after 3, the decimal point is kept here. So it become now 23.4. So here in 100 there are 2 zeros. So that is why the decimal point is shifted 2 digits to the right. So it became now 234.0. So in 1000 there are 3 zeros. Then decimal point is shifted to the right by 3 digits. So then we get here one more zero. So 2340.0. See, we got the same product, 2340.0. So when you multiply any decimal number with 10, 100, 1000 or 10,000, then the digits in the product are same as the digits in the given decimal number. But the decimal point is shifted to the right by as many digits as there are zeros in the number, like 10, 100 or 1000. If there are 3 zeros in the given number here, then the decimal point will be shifted to the right by 3 digits. Okay. So when decimal number is multiplied by 10,000, then in 10,000 four zeros will be there. So the even the decimal point also will be shifted to the right by four digits. So when you multiply any decimal number by 10, 100, 1000 or 10,000, then the digits in the product are same as the digits in the given decimal number, but the decimal point will be shifted to the right by as many digits as there are zeros after one. Now let us find other products also. So let us take 1.789 and we will multiply by 10. 1.789 you will multiply by 100. 1.789 you will multiply by 1000, and 1.789 is multiplied by 10,000. Now let us find the products. Now here there is one zero in the given number 10, so the decimal point will be shifted to the right by one digit, so it becomes now 17.89. Now in the second case, in 100 there are two zeros after one, so the decimal point will be shifted two digits, so it becomes now 178.9. So 178.9 is a product. Now when 1.789 is multiplied by 1000, there are three zeros after one. Now the decimal point will be shifted three digits to the right, so it becomes now 1789.0. Now next, so when 1.789 is multiplied by 10,000, so there are four zeros after the one, so the decimal point will be shifted four digits to the right. Now it becomes now 178.90. So there are only three digits after decimal point, but it should be shifted to the right side by four digits, that is take zero, then 0.0. So in this way we can multiply any decimal number with 10, 100, 1000 or 10,000.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.